Hi there guys, and welcome to Guitar Interactive. My name's Tom Quayle, and today I've got a review of the Dean MAB1, which is the Michelangelo Batio signature model. The MAB1 features this rather impressive artwork on the front. There's quite a few MAB models. This one has the skulls and chainmail and all sorts of things going on there. It's a rather fantastic looking piece of artwork. The body of this guitar is an older tone wood. It's got an older top. It has a maple neck, which I'll show you around the back in a second, and an ebony fretboard. We've got perloid inlays, medium frets, Grover tuning pegs, and a very, very cool Floyd Rose tremolo system with a locking nut. EMG pickups. These pickups are basically an 81 in the bridge, EMG 81, an 85 in the neck, and an SA in the middle. These are active, of course. We got five-way pickup select switch, tone and volume, and then obviously the bar for the whammy. Okay, turning over. It's an opaque finish, all black. Bolt-in neck, there's your maple. Battery compartment just here. As you can see, labeled battery, kind of useful. Obviously houses the electronics, as they're active pickups, they require a battery. I'm assuming it's a 9-volt battery. Then there's the housing for the springs for the tremolo system. Again, looks really solid. No construction flaws at all on this guitar. So nice instrument so far. Let's turn it back over. Okay, so let's have a listen to how the pickups sound. As I say, these are active pickups, so a lot of people would presume it wouldn't bring out the character of the guitar, but actually playing through these pickups today, I actually think they're pretty nice sounding. They're very high output, as you'd expect with a guitar of this nature, so I've had to roll the gain down on the clean channel quite a lot to actually get a clean sound, but the sound is actually a nice sound, a nice tone. So let's start with the neck pickup. This is the 85, the EMG 85. See what this sounds like through the clean channel of our Blackstar Series 1 200 head, which is DI'd into the desk. Here we go. A really warm sound. It's not kind of it's got lots of character to it. You can hear the older coming through in terms of tone. Incredibly easy to play, really, really easy. You want that with a shred guitar, obviously. Let's move down to the next position. This is combining the inner coil of the 85 with this SA pickup here. It should be a slightly thinner sound. Let's have a listen. Okay, nice, very nice tone actually. Let's move down to the middle pickup, have a listen to how that sounds. So they're very dynamic pickups actually, they respond really nicely when I was playing a little bit harder there. You can hear they respond really nicely to the pick attack. The actual attack there is really, really dynamic and strong, which is great. Really, really nice from this guitar. Let's move down one. Now we've got a combination of the 81 and the SA. Sounds like this. And then finally moving down to the bridge position, so listen to how that sounds. Okay, so all really musical sounds. They don't sound too much like kind of your standard classic active pickup. It's got a lot of character to it, the guitar, which is primarily probably down to the fact that it's really nice bits of wood that it's constructed from. It's got quite a bright sound due to the ebony fretboards and the older body. It's not a classic basswood with a maple top construction for a kind of 80s style shred guitar. This is a bit more unique, so great, great sound. Let's have a listen to the same thing now. We'll go to a lead sound. Have a listen to the same kind of thing. Now these are really high output pickups, so they're going to drive your amp really hard. It's designed to be played with lots and lots of overdrive. I'm not a shredder, so I'm not going to shred too much, but you'll get the idea of the actual guitar. So here's the neck pickup with power chords and then with a little bit of lead. Very, very fat lead tone, basically. This guitar is designed for that kind of particular setup. So through the Black Star, especially with its high gain lead channel, this guitar really, really, really sings. Let's try the straight down to the bridge pickup this time, same kind of idea. This thing's superb for kind of fast-picked runs. If we do something like... it just really, really, really is easy to play. I think it's got a set of nines on it at the moment, but the setup is phenomenal. You can just literally shred away until your heart's content, which is obviously what Michelangelo Batio is kind of renowned for doing. So have a quick listen to the three other positions, just really quick so you can hear how they sound. And then I'll talk a little bit about the tremolo as well. So let's have a quick listen to some power chords on the second position down. Okay, and then down in the middle position. And then down one again. Okay, so all the positions sound really, really musical. The fact that they're active means that you've got that real cutting sound no matter which pickup you're on. So great for this kind of style. Although actually, apart from the finish on the guitar, which I can't really see you doing jazz gigs with this guitar purely from the finish, but tonally, it's actually more versatile than you might expect it to be. You could use it on a variety of different gigs. You probably just have to hide. and play off stage if you're doing a jazz gig or something, you know, like a funk gig. It's really not designed to look right in that kind of scenario. But you know, if you're going for a guitar like this, you're going to expect to have some kind of crazy finish. Look at all the guitars from the 80s, you know, pink finishes with crazy, crazy finishes on the neck and all kinds of crazy paint jobs. So this really is from that era, and it certainly looks the part for sure. Okay, so one thing I did find, the Floyd Rhodes is superb, really, really good setup. I mean, they don't come better than the original, and all the high-end guitar manufacturers use Floyd Rhodes, the original Floyd Rhodes, in their construction. So from that respect, it's great. Holds its tuning incredibly well. If you do big dive bombs, go completely crazy. The guitar obviously remains completely in tune. That goes without saying for this. However, one thing I did notice is the actual arm itself is screwed in via a traditional setup where you've got a twisted thread, which you screw the actual arm onto. Now, with any kind of extended use, if you tighten it up, unless you use some kind of wrench to physically tighten it up as hard as possible, it comes loose fairly quickly and flops down, which is not ideal. But it is kind of a minor point, but it's irritating if you think that the arm's going to be there and it's dropped down and it's not there. It can throw you off your stride, of course. Okay, other than that, I have to say, great instrument. If you're in the market for a kind of 80s style shred guitar with a really cool finish, there's a few other finishes you could look at on Dean's website as well for this particular MAB guitar. But one that's not going to cost sort of thousands and thousands and thousands, you know, one that's not a custom job kind of crazy price guitar, this guitar probably will fit the bracket. Obviously it pigeonholes you in a very particular style of playing, but why would you be looking at a guitar like this otherwise? So, you know, you're not probably not going to worry about that if you're interested in this instrument. So go and check them out. Superb instrument. Go and check out the rest of the range as well. Hope you've enjoyed the review, and I'll see you next time.